Walaikum assalam. What's
your opinion on workplace? Is there is a pirated software or something? We have to work on that place. Is it haram or halal?
Well, there was a question that if we have a pirated software, working in a place which has pirated software, is it haram? Is it halal? What is the view? So, you know, this per se piracy of the software, I've given a talk on that. It's a long answer, more than half an hour, talking about the piracy. There are various aspects of look into it. One thing is there that there are many softwares which are produced in the world. They're very expensive. Normally, piracy per se is haram, general. But there are some software which many of the companies, they themselves introduce piracy so that it becomes famous. But all the people who are small companies, they buy pirated version for 100 rupees, 200 rupees, 500 rupees, it becomes popular. But the big companies can't afford, because if there is a suit filed against them, they get into problem. So they purposely make the software popular by creating piracy themselves, making it popular, and those top companies, they buy the version which is very expensive. 100,000 rupees, 200,000 rupees, or 50,000 rupees. So now, if the piracy has been encouraged by the company itself, and if you're using that software, I feel Islamically there's no problem. If the company hasn't encouraged and using it, then it is wrong. So all this, the various aspects to it, but there's a difference between, are you talking about Islamic software or are you talking about general software? If you're talking about Islamic software, the ruling is different, pros and cons are there. If you're using general software, like Microsoft or Windows, etc., so the thing is, this becomes a gray area. It's a gray area. But one more thing. There are some companies which say, fine, you buy one, second one you pirate, no problem, they're not object. So even the boss comes to know. Normally when you go, the software is expensive, 100,000 rupees, 200,000 rupees, $5,000, $10,000. You buy one, and they say, fine, you have got three computers, buy one, remaining you copy, no problem. So the company also knows about that, indirectly, not in writing, but verbally they're agreeing. And then if you use such a software, there's no problem. Or suppose you have 10 computers, 10 computers, kam se kam do to kharido. So buy two, and the remaining, it is a gray area. Generally, piracy per se is haram. If you ask me in yes or no, piracy is haram. Generally, if you ask me, is piracy of software allowed or not? One word answer, it is haram. But then depending upon the way the company functions, then they have educational version of it. So various loopholes they have given. So if you know that you are within the purview, and then if you use, and you buy a software from official vendor, it tells you fine that you can use one pirating, you do, etc. But generally, only using pirate software per se is haram. And you are working in that company, see, you as a worker, you can tell the boss, see, this is pirated. So you as a worker working in a company, they are using pirated copies, you don't fall directly in that aspect of creating sin. Because you have told him, if he tells you it is not pirated, you won't come to know whether it's pirated or not. Fine. So you as a boss, the problem is different, the question is different. But you as working in the company, if the boss provides you something, you are doing your job, you are working, so directly you won't be held responsible for that. Hope that answers the question. You had some question, brother?